Okay, so in this video, let us discuss another pattern printing program asked in Wipro's coding interviews. This is a program to print Floyd's triangle. So you can see a triangle like this. Basically, it is filled with numbers and there is a pattern. If you observe, first line has one number, second line has two numbers, nth line has n numbers. And what is the speciality? All these numbers are consecutive in nature. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, like that. So how are we supposed to print this? So this resembles the half pyramid. Whatever program we wrote for half pyramid, it resembles that only. If you don't know how to print half pyramid, you can check a video that I have made, and you can see there how to print half pyramid. But what is special over here? Over here, we can observe that in the first line, one is printed. In the second line, 2, 3 is printed. So my one has got incremented to 2 in the second line. In the third line, 4, 5, 6 is printed. So my 3 has got incremented to 4. So we can observe that whatever is the last number in that respective line, the next number is the starting number in the next line. So we just need to keep a count variable. Let us set a count variable equal to 1. And after every line, let us increment this count. Let us do count plus plus after every line. And also we need to increment count within that line also, because we need to print 2. So we have to increment count to 2. We need to print 3. So we need to increment count to 3. So basically it turns out to be a very simple program. Let us take two variables, I and J. Let us say I want to print 5 lines. So if I want to print 5 lines, I need this nested for loop, because this is the structure for half pyramid. Let us keep a count variable equal to 1, and let us print count and let us increment count and let us see what happens now. So automatically we get the triangle. So this triangle, whatever we wanted to print, we get it. If you want to give space, you can give space. So basically you have to do nothing. You have to just make a nested for loop and keep a count variable initially set to 1 and just keep incrementing count. You will get the Floyd triangle. So this was a simple program. It was asked in a Wipro interview question, and it just tests your basic C programming, nested for loops. So don't ignore easy questions. I know most of you will be feeling, why is it so easy? Yeah, I know it is, but just keep revising, you know, nested for loops. Next program I will make on diamond. Diamond is not so easy for beginners. Like, you need to know how to make a loop for space and where to print, where not to print. Then we'll move on to other complex patterns like hollow diamond, inverted triangle, Pascal triangle. So keep watching and stay tuned for more. Bye.